Hi everybody, this is Carrick with Angry Centaur Gaming. You know a game did well when out comes an expansion where the devs said, screw it, we know the game is so cool, we don't even need to make it require the original. And thus, Wolfenstein the Old Blood was born, taking place prior to the most excellent New Order. Actually, I'm pretty sure it also involved voodoo magic and a pack of flightless birds, but that's just because those two things are awesome, and designers would be stupid not to include them. You see, unlike that kind of magical combination, Wolfenstein's always been completely uncomplicated. The kind of significant other that is all action and rarely makes you answer questions like, did you think about me when I was gone? Are you thinking about me now? Do you like her legs? No, Wolfenstein is battle romanticized, down to the constant distillation that old Quake fans and Unreal 1999 gamers adore. Run, shoot, reload. And this also has always helped Wolfenstein. That's always been a game series that sort of communicates a lean, mean shooter with a story developed by the gameplay and not the other way around. Let's see if this game is a sleek reminder of past Wolfenstein titles with possible improvements to a couple issues and a new story and location, or if it's just a rehash, a sad, sickening comedy of sibling mimicry that reminds us of that creepy uncle who always talks about his time in Vegas with twins. And as always, this review is caffeinated, which means a speedy symphony of synonyms delivered at subliminal speeds to your spirit listeners. Graphics are up first. This is honestly identical to the New Order. There isn't much difference, and luckily the game allows you to adjust, modify, and fiddle hump a boatload of features until your heart's content, even messing with things like texture compression and other slightly more arcane graphical enhancements. Luckily, other than a strangely heavy anti-aliasing hit when I turned it on, the game really ran rock solid, with the only occasional hitches when a cutscene was loading into a new level, and that was actually pretty rare. It moves fast, looks good, and plays quick, and those are the requisites for Wolfenstein. I've always found enemy design in these games to be a bit hit and miss, and Old Blood's no exception, with some of the enemies directly ripped from the Order, obviously, and some other designs working well to add a bit of freshness to the game, but this is not going to wow you in the design department. And one part of the game I can say I was not too impressed with at all, and that's the environments. Despite the fact that you're returning to the scene of the original crime, as they say, it just never grabbed me, and even the expected but performed anyway gondola battle was more about the gunplay than the location it was in. And yeah, that's sort of complaining about something good, but at the same time we're talking about graphics here. Though I admit I do have a fondness for the catacombs level that reminded me a little bit of Indiana Jones and that search for Sean Connery's hat. I would say as a whole package, it's pretty good. Sound, music, and voice. Sound is up first, and I love it. The shotguns slam low-end ratcheting shells that also carry a slight tinny and plasticky sound. That's obviously on purpose and offers a really good thick mixture to that weapon in particular. The machine guns rattle off excellent sounding ammunition that may roar across a level, but it doesn't end up hiding the sound of the gun's action. The one place I still find disappointment is the silent weapons. For some odd reason, they sound worse in this game, and I just can't believe that the sound of a rubber band hitting a wet ball sack is supposed to in any way indicate impact. And yeah, I've heard that before. But no, seriously, that gun just sounds too solitary in its mix and too weak to excite me, though I end up using it to hell in the game anyway. Now, the sound mixing in the past games have had some complaints. I felt it was overall better in this game than in past titles. Music. You know, Machinegames used Mick Gordon for the soundtrack, and he's created a unique if somewhat cautious soundtrack overall. It's not as if he didn't take chances, because he did, going so far as to ram random shit into his piano while playing, because he's an artiste and it simply must be done. No, seriously, I have no clue why he did it. And in the end, it's a good soundtrack, but there just isn't any actual particular track that grabbed me or raised my emotions, nor were there any that were bad. It was just basically adequate, regardless if it was a cutscene or I was neck deep in fucking enemies. Voice. You know, the voice is actually excellent, with BJ occasionally offering little tidbits and life advice here and there, and the surrounding supporting characters are really good for the most part, with the main baddie being particularly fun to listen to. Though I swear I heard some of them lose a bit of accent here and there, but in the end, I can't ding them for this game, as it isn't called Castle Dragon Natural Speaking. Who gives a shit as long as they usually sound subtly bad guy-like? And now we come to gameplay. You know, Have you ever had that really bad day when everything seemed to start out all kinds of wrong and you weren't 100% sure that fate, karma, and the universal wheel of doom wanted you out and about at all? That's pretty much the ramp up to BJ and his tale of woe at the starting of this game. You see, you enter Castle Wolfenstein under deep cover as German military, only to be told right away that your German sucks and you shouldn't speak. Oh yeah, that'll end well. What starts off as a very stealthy and oddly un-Wolfenstein-like beginning level ends up rolling in front of you for 6 to 8 hours of typical shoot the enemies in the face good time. And I gotta say that's good because I like shooting stuff, I like explosions, and I also like wolves even without the Stein. And this game not only has that, it also has the same excellent gameplay that most gamers expect if they had any experience with the New Order. This is a game dialed into its destruction zone, and within a short amount of time, possibly 3 to 4 minutes, all of Nazi Germany wishes they had never, ever captured BJ. With insanely cool melee weapons, perks for performing specific actions within the game, and some upgradable weapons, as well as a couple that are just plain fun, BJ tears through levels like a tornado that comes when called by name. One of the things I've always liked about this character is always all feet and hands and barrels, and little within the game ever seems to really slow him down. Some enemies have unique attack requirements that might require a little bit of strategy or stealth in a battle, but in the end, even BJ's stealth is loud, hammering his pipe into the head of an enemy, then using it to climb up the broken side of a cavern, then minutes later using it to prop open a Nazi control room door like the worst can of sardines ever. The trusty pipe is a thing of beauty. While the semi-automatic shotguns can tear through just about anybody in one shot, they are awesome. And possibly two shots if you happen to shoot a lot of people in the nuts, which for some reason in this game, and I don't want to discuss it here, I have a habit of. Listen, Old Blood doesn't offer much in the way of new hotness other than continued gameplay in the Wolfenstein world with a couple unique factors thrown in. It's not going to knock your socks off with some new feature, but it does have wickedly solid gameplay, the likes of which many shooters flounder trying to locate and end up throwing flashy graphics at the fans, hoping no one will notice. This is a good 6 to 8 hours. It depends on your gameplay speed and has some challenge maps that are unlockable, of course. Though, with the narrowed focus and overall smaller game slice, I actually found these challenge maps to be a bit more tedious in overall, like, feel, I guess, than New Order in the game before. Now, there are a couple issues that continue with Old Blood. You do get the occasional enemy who gets shot and then apparently has a French stroke, which is basically shaking uncontrollably at like 1,000 miles an hour and then shooting off into the darkness to die alone. And it can be off-putting to see a character that apparently has levitated 7 feet above the ground and headbutted the earth so hard that they've joined forces with it in some kind of ecological co-op match. Ragdoll glitches aside, I also found that a couple places in some maps were a bit hedgy in their design, leaving me looking for the exit and finding it in the oddest place, or not being able to jump to an obviously jumpable area simply because someone had forgotten to program in that ability at that location. Very odd. Control was a mixed bag, and I played through half the game with the Xbox 360 controller, which worked well, but never seemed to give me that movement and scoot factor that I needed in the harder difficulties. And the other half was with the mouse and keyboard, and for the life of me, I had all kinds of issues with sensitivity, so much so that it really did dramatically affect my gameplay until I became accustomed to it. There was just something off, and no matter what settings I tried, it never really felt exactly accurate or as I felt it should. Now, when it comes to fun factor, you know, I admit I liked it for the most part. This is a game where the price meets the time somewhere near your fun nubs, and it's actually excellent gameplay mixed with fairly unique vistas and a somewhat okay soundtrack. This isn't a game that has gone out to change the world. It's gone out to add a snippet of that world to an overall fiction, and that actually helps. I enjoyed that. Though I could do without the challenge maps, luckily the game's unlocks are suitably easy to get for the most part, so you usually won't find yourself artificially out of sorts when it comes to the secrets in the game. But I really can't lie, at times the control did seem to slightly bother me, and maybe there's some INI file I need to change, maybe there's something, you know, this is a PC game, so there could be multiple things occurring. You know, it was playable, and I beat it on a harder difficulty, so it's possible. It's just it never felt exactly how I wanted it to. So as you know, I rate games on a buy, wait for a sale, rent, and never touch it again rating scale. This is a buy. I mean, for $20, you get 6 to 10 hours of Wolfenstein gameplay and a bit more lore to add to your brain sieve labeled Shit I Know About Wolfenstein. As an expansion, this game is a success. It may just not be as successful or considered as successful as some other big games expansions would be. So that's it for me. I really hope you liked the video. If you did, hit like. If you did not, hit dislike. Make sure to comment if you can and share the video if you like it. Peace out.